In 2024, there will be a once-in-a-lifetime stellar explosion, visible from everywhere. In the constellation Corona Borealis, there is a very special star called T Coronae Borealis, better known by its acronym TCRB. This star is actually a binary system containing two stars that are very different. But what's so special about this binary star? Recently, a group of scientists from Louisiana State University published a study on this star in the Journal for the History of Astronomy. In that article, they explained that this star could be about to experience a colossal explosion known as Nova in 2024. But what is a nova, and how do we know precisely when it will happen? Keep watching to find out. T Coronae Borealis. This is a 10th magnitude binary star, meaning it's not visible to the human eye and is barely visible to amateur telescopes. TCRB is a binary star, meaning it's not a star but a star system of two different stars. It's known that most of the stars in our galaxy are of this type. There are theories that in the past, billions of years ago, the Sun may have had a companion, and both the Sun and its companion mounted around a common center of mass. Today, this theory is still open in the scientific community, and many astronomers consider the possibility that the Sun had a companion in the Sun's past. Binary stars are exciting in scientific research because each star that makes up the system can influence the other differently. The stars that make up a double star system are usually called components, and each component has different characteristics. The binary system TCRB comprises a red giant star and a white dwarf star. The system's two components orbit around a common center of mass every 228 days. The orbit is nearly circular and tilted at an angle of 67 degrees. The two stars are known to be extremely close, separated by only 0.54 astronomical units. To give you an idea of how close they are, this distance is less than the distance from Venus to the Sun. In other words, the two stars are so close that the gravitational effects of one influence the other. The biggest star in the system is a red giant in its last stage of life, before becoming a white dwarf. On the other hand, the hottest component of the system is a white dwarf surrounded by an accretion disk. This accretion disk is the factor that produces novae. But how exactly are they produced? Origin of novae. A nova is a transient astronomical event that causes the sudden appearance of a bright, apparently new star, hence its name nova, which in Latin is written nueve and means new. This appearance of a new star is temporary and can last for weeks or months. But as we mentioned, it's not the appearance of a new star, but rather a phenomenon that unleashes a brightness, which, seen from Earth, gives the impression that a new star appeared. But how does a nova occur? A nova forms from two main sequence stars in a binary system. Normally, the stars in a binary system are very similar. However, most of the time, one of the two stars will have a greater mass than the other. So the star that has more mass will consume its fuel faster and reach its final stage of life sooner. When one of the two stars evolves into a red giant, it begins to die, ejecting its outer layers and scattering all the materials it formed during its lifetime into a planetary nebula. When the star has ejected all its outer layers, in the end, only its core will remain, which we know as a white dwarf. This type of star, although they seem small and cold, still retain a large amount of mass. The mass of a white dwarf is comparable to that of the Sun, while its volume is comparable to that of the Earth. However, this new white dwarf is still gravitationally anchored to its sister, which has not yet reached its last stage of life, and both continue to orbit around a common center of mass. When the second star reaches its last stage of life, it begins a process similar to the first. First becoming a red giant and then gradually beginning to free itself from its outermost layers composed mainly of hydrogen. However, at this stage, something extraordinary happens. The outer layers released by the second star begin to be absorbed by its companion, the white dwarf. As a result, the white dwarf constantly captures matter from its companion's outer atmosphere, and begins to form a hydrogen accretion disk around it. Since the white dwarf is made up of degenerate matter, hydrogen does not inflate, but its temperature increases significantly, becoming ionized hydrogen. Hydrogen fusion can occur stably on the surface of the white dwarf, resulting in a supersmooth X-ray source. Still, hydrogen combustion is usually thermally unstable and quickly converts into other heavier chemical elements. This creation of elements from hydrogen causes an exothermic reaction that releases enormous energy. This ejects the remaining gases from the white dwarf's surface and produces a bright light in an explosion. The burst is what we call nova, a drastic increase in a star's luminosity. This brightness increase can be remarkably rapid or gradual, so once the burst of light occurs, little by little, the brightness decreases until the star returns to its average brightness. The time it takes for a nova to decay by about 2 or 3 magnitudes from maximum optical brightness varies depending on the size of the star. Fast novae will normally take less than 25 days to decay by 2 magnitudes, while slow novae will take more than 80 days. What type of nova is T Coronae Borealis? TCRB is classified as a recurrent nova because it has had different novae with a certain periodicity since this star began to be observed. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. How do we know it will explode in 2024? As mentioned earlier, TCRB has had explosions in the past that are currently recorded by the American Association of Variable Star Observers, or AAVSO. The first occurred on May 12, 1866, and the second on February 9, 1946. Both events were TCRB explosions. They reached a magnitude of 2 and were bright enough to be observed with the naked eye. The astronomers discovered, however, that before the star's luminosity increases, it decreases its brightness a bit. In his research, scientist Justin D. Linford of the Department of Physics and Astronomy of West Virginia University analyzed the star's state of activity between 2015 and 2016 and realized that during this period, the star became much brighter than usual and expelled more significant amount of X-rays. The scientists collected information from different radio telescopes and telescopes, obtaining data with which they could create a model of the star's behavior. They concluded that the star's behavior today is very similar to what was observed in the 1940s when the last explosion occurred. To corroborate this, they compared the data obtained with the data from 1938, and the similarity was evident. The way the star behaved during 2015 and 2016 is very similar to how it behaved in 1938, 8 years before the 1946 nova occurred. According to current records, this corroborates existing information about past TCRB explosions. In 1945, a year before the 1946 explosion, astronomers observed that the total brightness of this star decreased by 2 orders of magnitude, from plus 10 to plus 12. Remember that in astronomy, the greater the magnitude of a star, the fainter its brightness. So the higher the magnitude, the more difficult it will be to see with the naked eye. The maximum magnitude that the human eye can observe is approximately 6 or 7 magnitudes. From those numbers onwards, our eyes are no longer able to perceive anything. That is, if you try to observe a star magnitude 8, 9, or 10, you simply will not be able to. That's why this star is very difficult to observe. It can only be done with special telescopes or binoculars. Back to the main point. Just 1 year after TCRB dimmed its brightness, there was an explosion that could be observed from Earth as a nova. This explosion increased the brightness of TCRB until it reached a magnitude of plus 2, so it could now be seen with the naked eye. However, on May 11, 1866, astronomer John Birmingham observed this star for the first time when it suddenly appeared in the sky. At the time, Birmingham didn't know it, but in reality, that star hadn't just appeared. What had happened was that he had just discovered a nova. It's thought that it's most likely that a day before the discovery by Birmingham, the star TCRB dimmed its brightness slightly and then gave way to the explosion. In summary, we have a pattern that repeats before the star is going to explode like a nova. This pattern is as follows. First, for about a year, TCRB decreases its brightness and then returns to its initial brightness. Then 7 years later, its brightness decreases again for a few months. Finally, a year after the last dimming period, it explodes in a nova that increases in magnitude up to 8 times and makes it visible to the naked eye. Astronomers' observations indicate that last year, 2023, TCRB had a decrease in brightness, just 7 years after the last dimming period that occurred in 2016. This means that TCRB will undoubtedly explode again in 2024 and produce a nova that will be visible to the naked eye. How and where to observe it? An insane curiosity, we don't like to be sensationalists, so we'll be honest with you. This event won't be repeated in 80 years. But unlike the solar eclipse of April 8th, this one will not be able to be seen so easily. Remember that TCRB is a star of magnitude 10 that is not visible to the naked eye. And unless you have experience looking for objects with a telescope, it will be very difficult to find it. We also don't know the exact date on which it will happen. It's thought that it could happen between April and September of this year. So there is a margin of several months in which it can happen. When it happens, you should look for a star of magnitude 2 in the sky. Magnitude 2 stars are not as bright as you imagine. Actually, from magnitude 1, they are already difficult to find. But so that you know exactly in which region of the sky you should look for it, just remember that TCRB is located in the constellation Corona Borealis, just below the corona, on the left side of the star Alpheca. On a typical night, you can observe Corona Borealis as a small semicircular arc right in the middle of Bootes and Hercules constellations. This is where TCRB burst will appear as a new bright star going from a magnitude of plus 10 to a magnitude of plus 2. So it will have a brightness similar to that of the north star Polaris. Once its brightness peaks, it should be visible to the naked eye for several days before dimming again, possibly for another 80 years. Finally, it would be best if you did not forget that this star is located approximately 3,000 light years from Earth. In reality, the light we see from this star is the one that came out of it 3,000 years ago. And we will not know everything that is happening in that star right now until the year 5024. That is, the nova that we will observe this year already happened 3,000 years ago, but the light of that event will only arrive this year. Now we want your opinion. On what date this year do you think the TCRB nova will occur? Write your prediction in the comments.